wherever you are joining us from in today's service, it might be your good morning, afternoon, or evening, but I want you to be assured that God is with you wherever you are. This is St. Andrew's Church Air, bringing service to you today, the 26th day of July, 2020. Let us worship God. Our call to worship is from Psalm 119, verse 129 to 136. Your statutes are wonderful, therefore I obey them. The unfolding of your words give light. It gives understanding to the simple. I open my mouth and pant, longing for your commands. Turn to me and have mercy on me, as you always do to those who love your name. Direct my footsteps according to your word. Let no sin rule over me. Redeem me from human oppression, that I may obey your precepts. Make your face shine on your servant, and teach me your decrees. Streams of tears flow from my eyes, for your law is not obeyed. Let's turn our hearts to God in prayer. Let us pray. Eternal and Holy God, almighty and merciful, maker of all things by your power, ruler of all things by your wisdom, we glorify your holy name with heart and mind. All praise and adoration be given unto you in this generation and in generations to come. Most merciful Father, we acknowledge and confess our many sins. We have transgressed your holy laws, neglected your word, and have walked in our own ways and fulfilled the desires of our own hearts. Have mercy on us, Lord, have mercy. Forgive our sins and increase in us the grace to true repentance through our Lord Jesus Christ. Eternal and ever blessed God, be pleased to bless us in this service with your Holy Spirit, that he may impart in us thoughts higher than our thoughts, prayers better than our own prayers, and powers beyond our own powers. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord, who taught us our Lord's Prayer, saying, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Thy kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and glory forever. Amen.
In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe, this gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid, here in the death of Christ I live.
Taken from the book of Romans, starting at verse 26. In the same way, the Spirit helps us in our weakness. We do not know what we ought to pray for, but the Spirit himself intercedes for us with groans that words cannot express. And he who searches our hearts knows the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints in accordance with God's will. And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. For those God foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the likeness of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brothers. And those he predestined, he also called. Those he called, he also justified. Those he justified, he also glorified. What then shall we say in response to this? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own Son, but gave him up for all of us, how will he not also, along with him, graciously give us all things? Who will bring any charge against those whom God has chosen? It is God who justifies. Who is he that condemns? Christ Jesus, who died, more than that, who has raised to life, is at the right hand of God, and is also interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble, or hardship, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or danger, or sword? As it is written, for your sake we face death all day long. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demon, neither the present nor the future nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. And may God bless the reading of his holy word.
Let us prepare ourselves to hear the word of God. Be still, for the presence of the Lord, the mighty God, is here. Let us pray. O God, without your help, we are not able to please you. Mercifully grant that your Holy Spirit may in all things direct and rule our hearts through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The topic of our homily this morning is God is at work for your good. God is at work for your good. Every year, BibleGate.com releases a list of the most searched Bible verses on their website. In most cases, Romans chapter 8, verse 28, which is part of the scriptures read to us this morning, is among the top 5 verses of the year. NIV translation renders it as follows. We know that in all things, God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. This favorite verse is sometimes misinterpreted. The King James Version translates it as follows. All things work together for good to them that love God. But often, only the first 6 words are quoted, namely, all things work together for good. It sounds nice, isn't it? But is it true? There is a condition, of course. All things work together for good to them that love God. To them that love God. If we love God, can we assume that all things will work for our good always? The good that we think is best for us. If we love God, can we expect God to always heal cancers? Provide everything that we need, or make us always successful in everything that we do? If things don't work out to us so well as we expect, is it because we don't love God enough, or is it because God doesn't keep his promises? Now listen. The verse is about how the things you and I think are bad are actually part of God's design for our lives. God's ultimate purpose is not a total mystery. It is found in the following verse, which is verse 29 of Romans chapter 8, which says that God's purpose for you and I is to be conformed to the image of his Son, that the Son might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. God wants us to be like Jesus Christ, so that many people will become God's children, brothers and sisters with Jesus Christ. God makes everything. He takes everything that happens to us, whether good or bad, and he uses it to transform us into the image of Jesus Christ. Glory be to God. Can we count on God to save us and make us his children? The answer is yes. Verse 29 and verse 30 expresses God's commitment to us, his children. Then we are asked in verse 31, if God is for us, who can be against us? I think the answer is nobody. But how really is God involved? Does he show up only when we desperately need to be rescued? Or is he always there in all things? Is he there only when our faith is strong, or when we deserve his favor? Or is he there only when we feel his presence and understand his ways? Or is he only active when we can see him at work in our lives? Verse 29 and verse 30 tells us that God is with us all the way. He is always there from beginning to the end. God had his eyes on us before even we had a chance to do anything good. God loved you and I before we were able to love ourselves. He knew you before you even knew yourself. This is God. David says in Psalm 139 and verses 15 and 16, my friend is not hidden from you. When I was made in the secret place, when I was woven together in the depths of the earth, your eyes saw my unformed body. All the days ordained for me were written in your book before one of them came to be. This is how David expresses his understanding of the presence of God in his life. Now, David said in that same verse, in that same psalm, such knowledge is so wonderful for me, too lofty for me to attain. Finally, God's ultimate plan is for us to join him in glory. Isn't this amazing? Now listen, if you are a child of God, God is at work in your life. From beginning to end, he is at work. God foreknew you. He loved you before you were able to love yourself. He has a plan that formed you and made you the you you are. He has a plan for your life. And the end of that plan is for you to be like Jesus and share his glory forever. This is the forever mystery that God has ordained and planned for you and I. That is why he reached out through people, through the church, through Bible studies, through circumstances of your life, or even events in the world. He uses his Holy Spirit also to touch you, your heart, to touch our hearts, so that our heart and mind may yield to his calling. But here is the question for you this morning. Are you a child of God? Is God at work in your life? If the answer is yes, good. But if the answer is no, I extend God's invitation to you this morning. God is calling you. God is inviting you to a wonderful fold that you will never regret joining all the days of your life. He is calling you to save you forever. He is calling you to heal you and to set you free. God is calling you because he wants you to see the light of his presence, so that his light will shine in all the dark places of your life. That is what God is doing. The manifestation and fulfillment of God's good plan for your life depends on how you respond to his call for you. It depends on your response to God's call for your life. Paul says in 2 Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 2, "Now is the time of favor. Now is the time of salvation." Let us pray. Now to him who by his power at work within us is able to accomplish abundantly far more than all we can ask or imagine, to him be glory in the church and in Jesus Christ to all generations forever. Amen.
Be changed, renewed, flowing from the grace that I found in you. Lord, I've come to know the weaknesses I see in me will be stripped away by the power of your love. Hold me close, let your love surround me, bring me near, draw me to your side. Let me see you face to face the knowledge of your love as you live in me. Lord, renew my mind as your will unfolds in my life.
Of thanksgiving and intercession for others before God. Let us pray. Almighty Father, beginning and end of all we are, and the hope to which we cling, it is to you alone we bring our sacrifice of thanksgiving and praise. You are our hope, the promise to which we hold. You are the peace this world cannot provide that overcomes our pride. You are our God, the one whose name we praise, to whom our hands are raised. In the darkness of uncertainty, when we do not know what to do, when decisions are hard to make, light of our darkness, hear us. In the darkness of our anxiety, when we are worried about the future, when we don't know where to turn, in the darkness of our despair, when life seems empty, when we feel there is no future worth seeking, Lord Jesus, you are the light of the world. Where there is oppression, injustice, and poverty, light up our darkness. Ever-present God, we pray for all whose journey has just begun, who tread carefully and heavy laden along unfamiliar paths, seeking guidance from fellow travelers. fearful of losing their way, speed up their journey, dear Lord. Keep them from harm and bring them safely into your promised land, where your kingdom is. At last, unburdened, they might find their rest in you. Gracious God, for those weighed down by ill health, bring wholeness to their body, mind, and spirit. For those weighed down by worry, bring wisdom, peace, and reassurance to them. For those weighed down by fear, bring freedom, release, and liberation. For those weighed down by sadness, dear Lord, bring comfort, strength, and joy. Guide us, gracious Lord, as we seek and make our way through this week, your feet revealing safe paths for us to follow, your calming voice giving confidence for us to continue the journey, no matter how difficult it may seem. Through unfamiliar, challenging, and often beautiful places, thank you, Lord, for answering our prayers. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you for joining in today's service. I trust you have been blessed. But be reminded again that God is working for your good. When you are weak, He is strong. Just keep step with the Master and He will see you through. Go therefore with the love of Christ our Lord. In the coming week and days, may the blessings of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest upon you and your family and your loved ones, and remain upon you all this day and always. Amen. I invite you to join us again next Sunday. I also want to remind you that very soon, doors of our church will be reopened again for public worship as instructed by Scottish Government and the Church of Scotland. You are always invited to join us as we worship God together in AyrStAndrew's Church. Until then, remain blessed.